Hey everybody, it's Ashley. How are you guys doing? I have a very exciting video that I've been looking forward to since I started this channel, and it has to do with March of the Mammoths. So this is an amazing readathon that is hosted by three booktubers who I've followed in like for years on my personal account. That is Jason from Old Blues Chapter and Verse, Lukash from A Cruel Reader's Thesis, and Alex from Big Out Books. And every March they do March of the Mammoths, where they consider a mammoth to be a book 800 pages or more, and you can pick one or you can pick more. There's no real rules or requirements as long as you start that book, and you don't even have to finish it in the month of March. So every year I had really good intentions and I put a big TBR out in my mind, and I put in a valiant effort, but because of my career and working at a hospital, I'd always end up picking overtime and I'd be exhausted. So it would sort of just give me little bits of time to read, and I didn't have long stretches to invest in these books. So I'm just looking forward to this March being able to dedicate my time, forget about goals and numbers, and just really immerse myself in these books, and that's the whole entire point. So what I thought I would do was show you all the big books that I have that are 800 pages or more, and maybe you can kind of help me choose what ones to read for this month. And even just, you know, I don't want to get stuck in a dry book, and a few of these are quite heavy nonfiction reads, so we'll see what I decide to choose. I might do an Instagram poll as well and have like a showdown of the books that I want to read. I'd also like to mention that there are so many 800 plus page books that I still want to read. I'm only showing you what I own because I have stopped allowing myself to buy any of them until I finally read some of these. So we're gonna just start with the one that I'm reading regardless, because it's also part of a read along that's going on for March and April. This is the book I just hauled, so you've probably seen it, and it is The Count of Monte Cristo. And Tanya from Bookish Topics is going to be doing a read-along. I'll leave everything down below so you have that information if you want to join in as well. And so I'm going to be starting it, but just not finishing it anyways. And then I have Middlemarch. And if you can see, I made it almost to the end a few years ago. Like, my tab is right there. And again, this was just a problem, not with the book at all, but with my situation and working nights. And I feel like when I put one of these down, because I'm working like 14 shifts in a row, and then you go and you just leave it and you want to pick up something small, or you're too tired to really focus. And that's what happened with this. I was loving the writing. I was loving the characters. It's just, I didn't have time. So, and have you ever noticed these Penguin Classics are really pretty to own, but you can see it just, the gold rubs right off where you're holding your hand the whole time. So I've stopped kind of buying these editions, although they look nice on the shelf. As soon as you read them, they're not so nice, but yeah, so that's that one. So the next book is a nonfiction book, and this is called Dreadnought. This is by Robert K. Massey. He is most known for some of his biographies that he's written on the Romanovs and Catherine the Great. I own both of those. I find him to be really readable. This is just following from the Victorian era to the Great War and, you know, the battle between the naval arms of Great Britain and Imperial Germany, and all of the people and events that surrounded that time. It is going to be probably a more heavy book to pick up, but again, like, what better time? If I'm going to leave this on my shelf, I should just start reading it now. But I don't know if anybody's read any of Robert K. Massey or if they've read Dreadnought. Let me know how you got on with it and what you thought of it and if it would be ideal for March of the Mammoths. Okay, so this is probably the book I'm most leery about, other than two more nonfiction that are coming up. But this is 4321. I don't know what really possessed me to buy this one. Probably when it was shortlisted for the Man Booker, and then when I saw it at the thrift store, I got really excited and bought it. It has a really interesting premise because it's following a boy and basically four different paths his life could take if there was different decisions and choices and twists of fate. I heard it is a bit long, and flipping from all of those four different lives can get a little bit confusing. But if you've read this, I'd really like to know what you thought of it. Because this one has been on my shelf for quite a bit, and I'd like to either tackle it or move on from it. And then another book that my mom picked me up. This is a really like yellowed edition of Gone with the Wind, but she found it at a thrift store. It doesn't smell. No, it doesn't smell. So that's kind of like the requirement for used books. You do the sniff test. And I actually haven't seen this movie. And my mom, when she brought it to me, she started reciting lines from it. And I was just laughing. She was doing these funny imitations. But it is just a classic. And it was actually, there was a poll done that it was the number one favorite for American readers next to the Bible. And I think that I read that on Goodreads, so I feel like I should read this, and I haven't. Actually, someone I worked with read it and really loved it too. So again, that's a contender. Okay, so the next one that I have on the list is Napoleon, A Life by Andrew Roberts. And this was mentioned on my 8 big books that I want to read in 2021 anyways, so it could be really good to read this month. It is kind of, I've heard, considered like the gold standard of Napoleon biographies. He had access to 33,000 letters, and he also visited almost all of the battlefields, so it just makes some of those scenes and time periods a little less dry to read about. But I've always wanted to read a biography on him, so I'm thinking this is high on the list for this month. But the other two, not so much, but I'm showing you them because they're on my shelves anyways. This is the Hundred Years' War, and it's strictly like a military history, more on tactics and things like that. So I don't think that this would be the best choice for this readathon. And then I also picked up The Penguin History of the World, which is over 1,200 pages, kind of at the beginning of humanity until post 9/11. So it's very all-encompassing, but might not be the ideal read for this readathon. Yeah. We'll see. Okay, so the next book is a classic, and it is Little Dorrit by Charles Dickens. I had started reading this and my work just got in the way and it got put on the back burner, but I was absolutely loving it. Katie from Books and Things has listed this as her favorite Dickens novel, or one of the top favorites. And I don't know if I want to read it. I had this kind of mission to read them all in order of publication date, so I started with the Pickwick Papers. So we'll see. And I only did that because I read a biography on Charles Dickens and how each of his books was just so heavily influenced with what was going on in his life at the time. But yeah, that's an option. And then I have a short story collection, which is the collected works of Oscar Wilde. I thought that this might be kind of good to read in between full-length works, so I could read just something witty and funny. I've only read 2 stories in here, so I'll read the whole thing again if I do choose this, but that is another option. This next book is a fiction book. This is Jonathan Strange and Mr. Norrell by Susanna Clarke. And I've heard such polarizing reviews on this. I feel like everybody on Goodreads either rated it 2 stars or 5 stars and nothing in between. But it might be kind of interesting to read this with Napoleon, since they are taking place at the same time. And it says on the back here that it mentions the war with Napoleon in the back. All I really know is that it takes place in England and there's magic involved. And the premise sounds really interesting. She's also put out a new book, Piranesi, which I've heard good things about and would like to read. It's definitely smaller, but I'd like to read this first. Tanya from Bookish Topics said that it's a really good book to read in a short period of time and just pick this and read nothing else and read it over a few days. So this might be actually perfect to read for this readathon, and it comes in at just over 1,000 pages. So there's that. So then I have another fiction read. This is Lonesome Dove by Larry McMurtry. It comes in just over 900 pages. And this is the only other book that I've included here from my 8 big books I want to read in 2021. Takes place in Texas, has heroes, outlaws, is a classic epic. So that is an option. And then I've got War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy. Not the best edition, but it's all I have, and I've only read Anna Karenina, and I read that last year. I loved it. I read it in almost under a week, I think like 4 days. I just really dove into it. So potentially, and there's also photos included in this one. I didn't realize that. Maybe I don't have the worst edition. Then I've got House of Government, which I mentioned on a haul recently. And this was, I had found out about this book from Steve Donohue. I think in 2017 he listed it as one of his favorite history books. And it is all about the Russian Revolution and how they had the House of Government, where all of the government officials lived in this apartment-like building that had tennis courts and libraries. It was just massive. And then it's basically a person by person, apartment by apartment account of the revolution up until the day that they were evicted from their building and either brought to prison or led to their death. So it's going to be really devastating. It also has a lot of diaries and interviews and letters included in here. This is, when I picked this up a couple weeks ago, I thought about reading it for March. So this might definitely be on the list. So far I have like 10 of these that I'm like, this might definitely be the one I'm gonna read. All right, so the last two books that I have to choose from on my shelves are The Mitfords. This is Letters Between Six Sisters. It is a chunky one, but it looks bigger than it is. It's only coming in at just over 800 pages, and it might be kind of perfect because it is written in letters, might be a little bit lighter, and I can read it in chunks just in between other books. It's also got some really good photographs in here, great pictures. And I think it's just going to be a great chronicle of history and, you know, understanding their relationship with each other. But they also had fascinating friendships. I mean, with Queen Elizabeth II, President Kennedy, Adolf Hitler. I think from that aspect, it'll be a really interesting read. And again, it has been on my shelf for a long time. This Tower of Mammoths is about to fall any moment. So good thing we are on the last one. Les Miserables by Victor Hugo. I just found this yesterday. I went to the thrift shop and this was sitting on the shelf waiting for me. It was only $1. And I could have probably bought this book 1,000 times over, but for some reason I was set on having this edition. I just really love this cover. And sometimes, you know, you all obviously are buying it for the writing, but there's something about just holding a beautiful book and I wanted to enjoy all of that experience. So I had held out. And I was lucky. I was beside myself at the shop when I found this. You should have seen me. I think Alex has read this as well, and she really enjoyed the experience of reading it. So let me know. That is all the mammoths I have to choose from on my shelves. So if you've read any or you recommend me reading any for this readathon, please leave it in the comments down below. I'll probably still have my little Instagram poll just for fun. So if you follow me there, you can join in on that as well. And there might not be as many videos in March because, as you can see, I'll be very busy, but I really want to just dive wholeheartedly into this and I can't wait. So I hope you guys are all well. Thank you for watching and let me know if you're going to participate too. I'll leave links for everything down below. Bye-bye.